Today I'm going to show you how to make beef and spinach pie. So I got here on the heat some ground beef. This is 1 pound. And I'm just spin browning this. Crumble this up as it starts to cook. As it begins to brown, we're going to add, this is about a teaspoon of kosher salt. Black pepper. I'm going to add an onion here that I just kind of sliced roughly. So I'm going to cook this, also I started off on high heat, but now I'm down on medium. So I'm going to cook this, just until the onion starts to cook. So I'm going to cook this for about a minute, and then we're going to add spinach. So it's been about a minute, and the onions have started to cook into this, starting to get tender. I'm going to add to this, some spinach. So I'm just turning everything. Try not to make a mess like I am. Doesn't take long, about a minute or two. As you see, as mine's is starting to wilt. I got some garlic here that I roughly chopped, 2 cloves. So it's been about 2 minutes since I added the garlic. You see everything is cooked down. Okay, so I'm gonna add about another half a teaspoon of salt using kosher salt. Another half a teaspoon. I'm gonna give this a mix. And I'm going to use my colander and I'm going to drain all of this. I'm going to drain all the fat, all the juice out of this. So I got my ground beef mixture here that I drained of all the fat. Teaspoon of oregano. Half a teaspoon of dried thyme.
1 tablespoon of smoked paprika.
Ounces of low-fat cream cheese. I'm putting the cream cheese in here. It's kind of at room temperature, but I'm putting over the hot ground beef mixture so it'll help melt the cream cheese. And also it will cool it down a little bit. So just mix until the cream cheese has completely been dissolved. So everything's just well combined. Okay, so the cream cheese has pretty much been mixed into the ground beef mixture. So I have some cheese here that I grated. This is a cup of Colby and a cup of Monterey Jack. So I'm going to add just 1 cup of this to the mixture. To this, 1 beaten egg. Don't add the egg while the mixture is hot. Your egg will scramble. This egg needs to work as a binder to hold everything together. Mix everything together. I'm going to set this aside and allow it to thaw. You can find this in your freezer section and the supermarkets in most places, usually around where the pie crust and frozen desserts are at. I'm going to take half of it, that one sheet, and I'm going to drip across. Because I haven't draped across the middle here. So just kind of lay it in there like I did. Just, it doesn't matter if it's messy or not. Also, I added to this a tomato. So, pour the pie mixture here in the middle of your. I'm going to take the rest of that cheese and sprinkle across the top here. So, I'm making an egg wash. This is one egg with a couple tablespoons of water. Just beat it until everything is combined. And I have a pastry brush. So what I'm going to do is start folding the top of the pastry over. I'm going to fold this over right here. Any parts that are a little too extra that you need to stick it together to each other, just brush a little bit of egg wash and seal it. So I'm going to brush a little bit of egg wash on this edge here. So, fold it over. Let's keep folding everything over like that. I'm gonna brush these edges here. Fold that over. Just fold everything over. Just to make it look neater. If it starts to dry, the dough starts to dry, just wet it with the egg wash. So I'm gonna brush the top down with some more egg wash here. I'm using a 9-inch tart pan also, or you can use a pie tin. Just use your pastry brush to kind of brush everything and lay it down to help it look neater as it bakes. Just kind of, you know, work with it very gently towards the end to just get everything to stick down together. This is going to go on a preheated 400 degree oven for about 30 to 45 minutes or until it's nice and golden brown on the top. Here is the pie. It's nice and golden brown. So I'm going to let this cool for about 5 minutes before I cut into it. So I cut it already. I just wanted to lift this out so you can see what the inside looks like. I hope you guys are seeing this really good. You can see the tomatoes and the onions and the spinach and the beef and the cheese. You can see the tomatoes and the onions and the beef, spinach, cheese. And our phyllo dough is nice. So now I'm going to give this a try. Should have got a knife, but I didn't. Look at that. Oh my God. Everything is just beautifully seasoned. Spinach is amazing in this. I hope you guys try this recipe and enjoy it. Please do not forget to rate, comment, and subscribe. And follow me on my social media sites. And also remember, Let's send love through food. Let's do what we can to stop our bullying and abuse. Thank you for watching.